So, I was correct. The not vigilant, not Christian Mario is a very prideful, foolish individual. And now I'm going to play the very satanic messages he is sending me. And he's just being very ridiculous. This is real time. He's still sending me friggin' psychotic messages. But let's just listen. To all of you out there who listen to his channel, listen to this prideful ranting. He's accusing me of being prideful. I snuff my pride. I'm humble, and I have confidence in what the Word of God says in English, that's all. But let's just listen to this. You're going to be really surprised, but listen.
Wow, you're actually being serious right now. You think this is Christ-like of you?
This is Facebook.
I'm not making myself into a victim, buddy. First of all, you didn't even follow the Bible and come to me in private, so I rebuke you.
And first of all, that's a scripture this guy always cherry picks when he gets exposed and rebuked. Oh, you didn't follow Matthew. Matthew is about talking about a local congregation in the church. All right, quit trying to use that for the internet and being rebuked over the internet. And Mario, people have contacted you in private already. You refuse to listen. So now it's open rebuke. Open rebuke is better than silent love. But good Lord, man, get over your pride. Listen to this, brethren.
For not actually following the Word of God, so you're in the one who's disobedience. And, buddy, you know why you don't want to debate me publicly? Because I would smoke you. I would so intellectually smack you down, like, literally, it would be the most disgraceful thing. I know you're scared. You don't actually want to show that you don't understand the Bible, because I will pre-wrath you to oblivion. Let's do it. Let's do it. I'm going to make a video challenging it. You want to go out and do this? Let's go toe-to-toe publicly. Let's bring the swords out, bud. You want to be a little player like this and play your dumb games? Call me a victim card. Play your big little tough rebuke there. You're so tough. You know your scripture there, Tim. Now you're a punk, bud.
Do you hear the way he talks? And you expect me to believe this man is saved?
Honestly, I can see it brewing in you. I can see that type of husky spirit, that legalistic, soon-to-betray, false brother spirit. I knew it. I saw it in you. I'm going to challenge you publicly. Let's go. Let's go. Let's duel. But you won't. You're a coward. You won't. I know you, Tim. I know you won't face me because you know. You know. Let's do it. Let's do it. Me and you. Tribulation. Let's do it. The rapture. Let's go. Toe-to-toe with DVC. You little coward.
And that's the man that many of you out there are following and actually have stuck up for in some of the comments of the recent video rebuking his annihilationism. That's pride. That's a child of Satan. I will debate you, my intellect. What? So now he's an authority? Sounds like a very angry Catholic from the Dark Ages. You know, Catholics would get so angry they actually would dig up bodies and behead them because that's how, like, satanic and crazy they were. That's what this guy sounds like right here. And he's calling me a joke. Let's debate, coward. I'm not even wasting another breath on someone who can't even give a reason for what he believes in debate. You're a Joan. He misspelled joke. Joke. That's who you're following. And I'm going to just rebuke him with another scripture. 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 16. But shun profane and vain babblings, for they will increase unto more ungodliness. Shun vain and profane babblings, but that's what he's doing right now. Very vain and profane. Very sick. I didn't realize he got triggered this much all by my video rebuking his satanic annihilationism. Ephesians 4 verse 30. Because he wants to debate about the topic of the rapture. He's a post-tribber, a posty-toasty. Well, posty-toasties have no real argument because many of them want to believe in eternal security, but guess what? If you can go into the tribulation and be tempted with the mark of the beast, you don't have eternal security in that time period. And it also contradicts this verse right here, in Ephesians chapter 4, verse 30. And grieve not the Holy Spirit of God, whereby ye are sealed unto the day of redemption. The day of redemption is the day of the rapture, not the day of the Lord. Two different things. How does that work if a Christian goes into the tribulation, any time period of it, when the mark of the beast is offered? It doesn't. It overthrows the whole post-trib system. We have eternal security. We are forever saved, and God will take us out of here before the tribulation. And if Mario wants to try to overthrow that verse, then guess what? He's going to have to preach that you can lose your salvation, making him even more of a heretic. But that's it. You know, shun vain and profane babblings, for they increase unto more ungodliness. Mario, you have literally just shown your pride and your very satanic attitude. You need to take a chill pill, man. All right, but God bless everybody.